Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei channel. Today in this video, I'm going to give you 6 tips to help you create a more perfect cloth simulation in Blender. So the first tip I'm going to give you will be to make bevels on the corner edges of whatever collision items you may have. So if I tab over into the edit mode and hit Control B, and I will create a bevel, and then using the mouse wheel, I can scroll that forward a little bit just to create some rounded edges. This will prevent those corners from poking through if you have the cloth landing on them. So any item that is going to be set with the collision modifier, then you want that to have rounded edges. So now I'm going to go ahead and create a plane, and I'm going to lift it up, and I am going to scale it. Notice these scale numbers. As I do, they change. Okay, this is tip number 2. If you change the scale numbers, you want to reapply the scale. So Control A and apply scale. This will reset these two ones, and that is very important as far as developing the cloth simulator. All right, so now what I am going to do is tab over into edit mode, and I'm going to subdivide this. The easiest and quickest way to do that, and this is tip number 3, is to right click and subdivide. Then opening up this box, you can use however many cuts you like. I would suggest at least 24, but the more you do, the better your simulation will be. I'm going to use 100 cuts, and that is the quickest way to do that. Okay, next thing I'm going to do is add the modifier itself. So I will go into the physics property tab, and I will select the cloth modifier. Now this actually, these are set up pretty good, and so you can see that if I go ahead and play this, now everything should be working fairly nicely already, except that there is one major problem, and you can probably see it, and that is that this cloth is not set to collide with itself. It is only colliding with the box underneath it. This is because in the cloth modifier, if you come down and you open up collisions, you'll see that by default, the self collisions is checked off. So tip number 4, make sure that you turn on self collisions under the collision drop down menu. Then when you go ahead and run this, you'll see that it will look much more realistic because it is now colliding with itself along with any other object that has the collision modifier added. Tip number 5, to make this look even better, you want to add a shade smooth to the cloth modified object itself. Right clicking under the object mode will allow you to select shade smooth, and this will make this look so much better than it did without the shade smooth selected. Tip number 6 is to go ahead and under the modifier properties tab, add a subdivision surface modifier to the cloth simulation. Make sure that you keep that subsurf modifier underneath the cloth modifier. It will work if you put it above. However, it will require a whole lot more computer power to do that. So leaving it underneath will make it run much smoother, but will create a beautiful looking cloth simulation. I'm Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel, and this has been 6 tips to help you create a more perfect cloth simulation in Blender. If you have any questions, or maybe you would like 6 more tips, then leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Thanks for watching.